In this video, we look at Educreations, a wonderfully simple but powerful screen capture app. Let's take a look.
To start your new lesson, click on the plus tab and it brings up the main whiteboard screen. So you can see here, you've just got a simple pen option with a few colors and you've got an eraser option as well. So obviously with the pen option, start drawing, and the eraser option, you can remove those drawings. If you tap again on the eraser option, you can clear the ink or clear the whole page. And if you tap and hold on the color swatches, you can actually change your color palette. So I might want to put gray in my palette there. All right, basically tap on the record button and you can start drawing your diagram. So that's a square, and now I've turned it into a cube, and then press pause. And if you want to continue drawing, press on that again and we'll clear the ink and we will draw this time a circle. You saw also there was an option when we tapped to clear the recording. Okay, so that's the basics of it. It's almost that simple. What are the other things we can do? Well, at the moment we've only got one page, so we've just got one page set up. You can tap down here and get yourself a second page. And on the pages, you can set up things beforehand. So there is a pro version where you can get some additional insertions that you can make. So you can insert web pages, maps, text documents. On the free version, you can insert text, images from your photo library, or take a photo with your camera. So if we tap on the text insertion, tap anywhere, and you can write in your text. You get that secondary menu, as you often do, to increase the size, decrease the size. You can arrow your way back through the text, as well as press and hold for the regular magnifying glass. And you can change your text color on the side of the toolbar there. If you want to highlight the text again, you get the option to delete it. You can duplicate the text and then drag it around. You can edit the text by tapping once again in that box. And there is an option to lock the text, so now it can't be manipulated or moved. Tap it again and you can unlock the text. Let's have a look at inserting an image. So it'll take you to your photo library. And there we go, we can drop in any old picture that we like. And now you get the options there: delete, rotate the image, duplicate. You can fit it to the height of the document, fit it to the width of the document, lock and unlock it as well. So there's some pretty useful options for your image. You can resize with the pinch and zoom. The other options in the basic version, you can duplicate a page and the ink, or you can just duplicate the page. So there we go, now we're onto our third page. That's the second page and the first page. And there is also the option to change your background, so white paper, line paper, graph paper, coordinate paper. You may find those useful as well. In the pro version, you can see here there is a pointer tool, so you'll be able to use a pointer as you're recording the video. But in the basic version, you don't have that one in there. Once again, we're on a new slide here, so let's just record a little bit more. This time, we're on the third slide, and we'll see what we can do there. There is the undo and redo buttons, but that's essentially the functionality of the screen capture screen. If we head back to the home screen, so we need to save our presentation, click back. You want to save as a draft or save as a finished video. So save as a draft for now. Takes us back to our home screen, and you can see here you've got drafts at the top and finished presentations at the bottom. At the moment, this is just me on my account. But you can also share with the Educreations community and upload for public viewing, or you can keep it as private viewing. To use those sort of options, you do need to click on the cog and it will sign up. You can also upgrade to Pro there. You can link up various accounts, Dropbox, Google Drive, Facebook, and you get some information. Let's open this back up. So we'll tap on that to open it back up. This time, we'll save as a finished video. And here you can give your lesson a title, let's call it a trial. You can add a description, whatever it might be. You can see your publishing options, so published, share with Educreations community, or keep it private, and you can tag it up with subject areas, particular subjects, and grade levels as well. That's especially important if you're going to share with the Educreations community. So click Save. To do this, I do have to log in or sign up, so I'll just log in with my details. So now that I've logged in, it's saved my lesson as a video, and you can see here it hasn't been uploaded to Educreations site. We can do that at a later stage, but if you click on it, it'll play your video and move you through the slides as you move through them in your recordings. We'll see it jump to the next screen in a minute. There we go, add the circle and go on to the third page. On the video screen, you can click done when you're finished. There is the export option from here, so you can send your video message, mail, Twitter, all the other open in options. You can save your video or copy a link to it as well. So let's click done. Back on this screen, to manage your presentations and your drafts, you can click on the select tool, select a lesson or a draft, delete, export, add to various classes. Your export options were the same as before, and also options to change the lesson details there as well that you'd already done. Let's have a look down the left hand side, because this is my profile, so this is all my lessons and drafts. If you click on the next one, you can actually create classes which you can share your lessons with. So if you tap on that, you can set up class name, description, subject area, and grade. When you finish putting in those details, click Save, and it makes a class for you. And then you can enroll students in a class so they can see lessons for that particular class. So you give the students the code, they can go and get the Educreations app, enroll as a student, enter that code, and they'll be able to see all the lessons under that code that you've assigned to that class. Let's go back to the main screen. So now when we have this, we want to add to a particular class. So now I can add it to Science at Year 7. So if we go back here, you can see my classes, Science at Year 7, there it is, and my students will be able to go and use that code and view any of the videos I've added there. So that is a fantastic option as part of the Educreations app. You can also go and see lessons you've favorited. So if you're watching a lesson, you can tick on the favorites. So up there you can see, tap that for the favorites. And then when you go back to this tab, you can see any lessons that you've favorited. You've also got a recently watched lessons tab, so you can quickly find them again. And you can also go and look at the Educreations community and see what other lessons have been made. So it's pretty good, you can get some good ideas there from other people, but you might find something that you can import and use straight away. So let's have a look at this gas laws one. There we go, it's importing that presentation. And you can favorite that.
The different gas laws that we've been studying.
Or export it as well.
So what a great addition to screen capture apps. I love how simple it is to use, and I also love the ability to make classes and assign videos to classes and then share them with the students via a code. Love to know what you think. Head across to the Facebook page at iPadagogy. Don't forget to follow the Twitter feed at i_pedagogy. And remember, subscribe for more excellent videos.